With 2020 now in the rearview mirror, let's take one last quick look back at the stats for the Canadian real estate market in December of 2020. How do these Canadian cities stack up with inventory, sales, and new listings? Sales we saw across the board in 2020 were ahead of 2019, and a lot of Canadian cities surpassed even their five-year averages. So we're gonna look at all that data. This is your Canadian real estate market update for January 2021. Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Bald Prairie Real Estate. If you're new here, my name is Matthew Pfeiffer and I wanna educate you about Canadian real estate. So I do monthly videos like this where we talk about the Canadian real estate market and what happened in Canada's major housing markets. And then in the weeks in between, I do educational content about buying and selling a house. So if you like this content, give me a thumbs up. If you love it, hit the subscribe button for me. Now this being January 2021, we're gonna take a look back at December 2020 stats as we always do. And we're gonna wrap up the year, quick recap on what happened in 2020. And I think you can break 2020 down into three phases. Phase one, everything starts getting normal as usual. Then we hit a giant pause and then the panic sets in at that point. There was a lot of negative fears about the Canadian real estate market. A lot of projections of some pretty significant declines in both the number of sales and prices in the Canadian housing market. As we know now, that didn't happen. So if you want an explainer as to why the Canadian real estate market didn't crash in 2020, you can check that out right there. I've already done that. And then the last phase, well, things got pretty hot in the Canadian real estate market, especially in the back half of the year. We saw a number of cities smash sales records through the back half of the year. And when I was making this video, I put up a teaser post in the community tab and I asked you guys, what city do you think smashed their five-year sales average? And there was a lot of really good answers, but only one person got it right. And that was my hometown, Regina, Saskatchewan, smashed their five-year sales record. Sales in the city were 13.5% above the five-year average. So a really strong year in the city of Regina, which has been through about 8 consecutive years of sales declines and price declines. So kind of nice to see in my market where finally sales start to pick up. Before we get into breaking down the stats in all these different Canadian housing markets, let's get you another terrible joke. I don't know if you guys knew this about me, but I'm a little bit of a musician. I'm in a band and we call ourselves The Blankets. It's because we're a cover band. If you've got a good joke, put it in the comments below. I love featuring them in future episodes of Bald Prairie Real Estate. What happened in the city of Regina for the month of December 2020? Well, let's give you a little bit of context. The five-year average number of homes sold in December in the city of Regina is 124. December 2020, 200 houses were sold. That capped off a year where we saw over 3,000 houses sold in the city of Regina. The five-year average is 2,600. So 2020 saw sales in Regina 13.5% above the five-year average, a really big year for sales in the city of Regina. There were 233 houses that were put up for sale in the month of December. That got us up to just shy of 5,000 houses put on the market for the year, but it is 5% below the five-year average. And starting off the year, we have less than 800 houses up for sale. That is a substantial decline from even just a few years ago, where we saw on average about 1,200 houses in the market to start the year. So with these strong sales and low inventory levels, it's pushed prices up throughout the year. Although we did see a little bit of a slip here in the last couple of months of year, where $273,000 is our benchmark price for the city of Regina. But where does this leave us for my Bald Prairie Real Estate biometer? I've got Regina still strongly in the get moving category. We've got low inventory levels across the board, still have strong demand. That is pushing prices up. And if we get anything resembling a normal spring market in the city of Regina in 2021, we're gonna have a very busy spring market where prices are gonna go up and we're probably gonna have some more bidding wars. We haven't seen that in Regina for a while. So if you think about buying a house in Regina, now is a very good time to start looking and get moving. This is gonna sound a little bit like a broken record, and that is sales surpassed last year. In Victoria, 631 homes were sold in the month of December. That's up 57% versus last year. It's down 20% versus last month. This is typical. Weather cools off, so does sales. There was 8,479 homes that were sold in Victoria last year. That's up 17% versus 2019, and it's about 1% above their five-year average for sales. They finished the year with listings also up about 1% from last year. The active listings to start the month, or start the year as well in Victoria, 1,279. That's down 34.5% from last year. It is also down 29.5% versus last month. The benchmark price for a single family home in Victoria, $915,000. That's up 7% versus last year, and it's up 1.5% versus last month. Condos did see about a 1% decline in price year over year. Now let's quickly look at the monthly pricing chart. Just remember, blue is this year, green is last year, gray is the five-year trend line. So you can kind of see what's going on for pricing throughout the year. If you look at the yearly trend line here, you can see prices have continued to increase in Victoria. We're seeing strength, obviously, in single family market, where the downtown condo market is a little bit softer, not substantial drops, but we are seeing a little bit of a drop in prices there. The Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer, I'm giving this one a get moving category because I don't see prices, especially in single family homes, slowing down in Victoria with strong demand and really low inventory levels. Condos, they're a little bit softer right now, but I think you're gonna see in the back half of the year, stronger demand for those, which will increase prices as well. Despite what a lot of people said about the Vancouver real estate market in the spring, 2020 turned out to be a fairly strong year for the Vancouver real estate market. Sales, they had 3,093 homes that were sold in December. That is up 53.4% versus last year. It's also up 1% from the month before. Now that December they just had is actually the most number of homes that have ever sold in the city of Vancouver for December ever. So pretty strong month there. They finished the year with just under 31,000 homes that were sold. That is down 1.5% from the five-year average. So strong year, not record-setting, kind of on pace for the five-year average for Vancouver. There were 2,049 new homes that were listed in the month of December in Vancouver. That's up 51.7% versus last year. It's down 41% versus the month before. There were 54,000 homes sold in Vancouver for sale in 2020. That is down just slightly from their five-year average, where they see just over 54,400 homes that are put up for sale on the market. To start the year, they have 8,538 active listings. That is down 0.8% from last year. It is also down 23% from the month before. The benchmark composite price, combining everything together in Vancouver, $1,047,400. That is up 5.4% from last year. It is also up 0.1% from last month. Prices for condos are actually up 2.6% year over year, but they're down 1% for last month. We saw last couple of months in Vancouver, downtown apartment prices are declining. Townhouses are up 4.9%, but they're down 0.5% from last month. That was a big month for townhouses though, the previous month. Looking at the monthly price trend, you can see that it isn't following the historical trends in Vancouver. Things are kind of splitting, going different directions. Talking with local real estate agents, they're expecting this low inventory and strong sales demand is going to continue to push prices and sales trajectories in the same direction through the start of 2021. And I've split the Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer in Vancouver into two. Again, we're going to go single families and condos. Single families, I have that strongly in that get moving category. There just simply isn't enough supply to keep up with demand right now. That's pushing prices up, and there isn't a ton of supply coming on stream for those anytime soon. Looking at the downtown condo market, I've got this into the start window shopping category. It had been sit tight for a while. I'm putting this in the start window shopping category because I expect you've got an opportunity here to take advantage of high inventory levels to get yourself a good deal on one before we see demand return in the back half of 2021 and start to push those prices back up. In the Calgary real estate market, we saw 1,199 homes sold for the year. That's up 40% versus last year. It is down about 17% versus last month. For the full year, they saw about 16,000 houses sold in the city of Calgary, which is right on pace their five-year average of 16,000 homes that were sold. 1,172 new listings came on the market in the month of December in Calgary. That's up 10.5% versus last year. It is down 32% versus the month before. There's about 28,000 homes that were put up for sale in the city of Calgary for 2020. That is down from their average of 32,000 in a year. 3,670 listings are up for sale currently in Calgary. That is down 20.4% from last year. It's also down 27% from last month. Their benchmark price in Calgary is $422,000. That's up 1.5% from last year. It is also up a quarter point from last month. So continued recovery in the city of Calgary. And for the first time, if you look at the monthly pricing trend line, they're above the five-year average. So we're seeing a bit of a recovery in the city of Calgary. Because of that continued recovery, the lower supply, the strong demand, and the expected stimulus coming in the Alberta economy, I've moved Calgary from the sit tight category to the start window shopping category to start off 2021. We're seeing Edmonton settle into a more typical pattern in the real estate market. 1,107 houses were sold in the month of December 2020. That is up 41% versus last year, but it's down 20% from the month before. For the year, we saw sales in Edmonton basically match their five-year average. There were 1,290 new listings coming on the market in the month of December. That is up 17% versus last year. It's down 30% from the month before. Listings were down about 12% versus their multi-year average. 5,005 active listings to start the year in Edmonton. Inventory is down about 25% versus last year, which was down 25% versus from the month before as well. So inventory levels are low in Edmonton compared to previous years. The average price in Edmonton is $362,000. That is up 2.61%. It is down 3.8% from last month, though. Again, average price is going to fluctuate based on what types of homes were sold. Benchmark price, I'll get it updated when it's available. Looking at the monthly price trend, you can see Edmonton's following that typical monthly trend. If you look at the yearly price trend, you can see some of the recovery that Edmonton has had this year. With those trends, much like you were seeing in Calgary, with stronger demand, lower inventory levels, expected stimulus spending in the Alberta economy, I've also moved Edmonton from the sit tight category to the start window shopping category with my Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer. Saskatoon continues to be one of the strong markets in Saskatchewan. As I've said before, it tends to be the market leader. So when you see trends in Saskatoon, they tend to replicate themselves in Regina and other markets in Saskatchewan. 274 homes were sold in the month. That's a big month for Saskatoon. They're up 35% versus 2019, down 24% from the month before. Sales were up 17.5% versus the five-year average. So when I put on my teaser post, which city smashed sales records with five-year average? I was looking for Regina. Saskatoon beat out Regina. I hadn't even looked at those numbers yet. So if you pick Saskatoon, I'll give you a point for that one. 347 houses were put on the market for sale. That's up 14% versus last year. It's down 19% versus last month. There are about 5% fewer homes listed in Saskatoon in 2020 than the five-year average. To start the year, they have 910 houses on the market. That is down 34% from last year and down 19% from last month. The benchmark price in Saskatoon is up 6% year over year. It's about $302,000. That is down about 0.5% from the month before. We see this if you look at the monthly trend, prices tend to drop a little bit in the winter in Saskatoon. But if you look at the yearly trend, you can see that prices have recovered a fair bit in Saskatoon, much like Regina, but we've got a ways to go before we get to those 2012, 2013 prices where things kind of peaked out in both Regina and Saskatoon. But that's why I'm giving the Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer a get moving category, because again, like Regina, if we see anything like a normal spring market in Saskatoon with these low inventory levels, it's gonna drive prices up in the city of Saskatoon. Moving on to Winnipeg, and my mom used to always tell me, if you can't say anything nice, just don't say anything at all. So we're not gonna talk about Winnipeg. Let's talk about sales though. 970 sales in the month of December. That's a 46% versus last year. It's down 20% versus last month. Sales ended the year 17% more sales in 2020 than they had in 2019. Big year for Winnipeg. 897 new listings came in the market in December. That is down 1.5% from last year and down 35% from last month. There are currently 2,316 active listings. That is down about 40% from last year. It's also down 28% from the month before. Average price dropped in Winnipeg, $342,000. Talking with agents there, it sounds like that was driven primarily by lower priced houses selling versus higher price, and that dropped that bench or that average price. I'll update charts with benchmark price when they become available. Inventory levels in Winnipeg continue to be exceptionally low, and that is driving price increases throughout the city. That's why I've got the Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer at Get Moving. If we have, again, a normal spring in Winnipeg, it's gonna be a very busy spring market in the city of Winnipeg. Whenever I look at the analytics of these videos, you guys clearly love the Toronto segment. It's my most popular part of the video. You guys loving here what's going on in the Toronto real estate market? Let's talk about it. 7,180 houses were sold in the month. That is up 64.5% versus last year. It is down 19% versus the month before. Where do they end up for the year? Well, there are over 95,000 houses that were sold in the city of Toronto for 2020. That is up 3% over the five-year average. So they surpassed not just 2019, but their five-year average. How about new listings? 5,865 new listings came on the market. That is up 66% versus last year. It is also down 50% from the month before. It wasn't too many months ago in Toronto where we saw over 20,000 listings coming on the market in just one single month. They finished the year with about 156,000 listings coming on the market. That is down 4% versus the five-year average. So we saw sales above the five-year average and listings below the five-year average for the city of Toronto in 2020. There are currently 7,892 active listings. That is up 6.6% from last year, but it's down 40% from the month before. And overall inventory is 15% below the five-year average in the city of Toronto. The benchmark price across the entire Toronto real estate market is up 11.5%. Now, this benchmark price is a composite index of all different property types combined together. You want to learn more about how that benchmark price comes together and why it's different than average price? Check out my explainer video, which I'll put a card to right there, as well as description or link in the description. Breaking it out though, we saw single family homes prices increase, benchmark price up 15%. The condo market downtown was up 2.4% on the year, but we did see prices start to drop in the back half of the year, especially last couple of months. Prices were coming down as supply increased. Looking here at the monthly trend line, you can see what's going on in Toronto for prices compared to previous years. Blue is this year, green is last year, and gray is the five-year average. And then if we look at the year trend, you can also see the spikes, but we did see a dip in prices in 2017. But for 2020, prices were on the rise. Where does this leave my Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer? Well, I'm gonna split this up into two segments as I often have. We're gonna go single family, and we're also gonna split it up into downtown condos. Single family, where they're not seeing enough supply come on to meet demand, and there's not a ton of projected supply coming on the market to meet that demand. Prices are likely gonna continue to rise, especially as we hit the spring market, where even more demand's gonna come on. So single family homes, get moving in Toronto. The downtown condo market, which I've had sit tight for a couple of months, I'm gonna move that to the get window shopping or start window shopping category, because I believe you've got a window of opportunity here to take advantage of oversupply in that type of property where sellers are getting a little more motivated to get those sold. You're probably gonna be able to get a better price for those. I do expect, though, the back half of the year to see demand pick up for that as we see the return of immigration, international students, and tourism, which will drive the rental market, pushing demand for those back up. So take advantage of this opportunity to look for deals for downtown condos in Toronto. Ottawa continues to be a very hot real estate market. 1,002 homes were sold. That's up 32% from last year. It is down 60% from the month before, though. Ottawa ended the year with 19,000 houses being sold. That is up 20% over their five-year average. There were 745 houses put up for sale in the month. That is up 42% versus last year. It is down 55% versus last month. Listings in Ottawa throughout the entire year were down about 10%. There are 960 active listings in Ottawa. That's down 45% versus last year, and it's down 40% just from last month. The five-year average inventory to start the year in Ottawa is 3,700 houses for sale, and they currently have 960 for sale. That's, of course, been pushing that average price up. Average price in the Ottawa real estate market, $603,000. That is up 20% from last year. It is virtually unchanged, though, from the month before. If you're looking here at the monthly trend line and the yearly trend line, you can see that prices continue to be increasing in Ottawa because of strong demand and low inventory levels. Real estate in Ottawa is booming. And that's why I've got for the Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer, get buying. There just simply is not enough supply to meet demand. And as we head into the spring market, that is going to push prices even higher. So try to get on that now before there's more competition for buyers pushing prices even higher. In Montreal, it's more of the same, where prices are up with sales and inventory is down. There were 4,613 houses that were sold in the Montreal real estate market in the month. That is up 32% from last year. It is down 7% from the month before. Sales in the city of Montreal were up 23.5% from the five-year average. That is driving prices up. Median price in Montreal for a single family home sits at $430,000. That is up 21% from last year. It is down 1% from the month before. I believe, though, this is due predominantly just to the price points that houses are selling at and not a change in supply and demand in Montreal. Because if you look at active listings, 5,981 new listings, that is up 31% from last year, but it's down 21% from the month before. Montreal ended the year with 67,700 houses that were listed. That is 1.8% below the five-year average. So listings were below the five-year average. Sales were above the five-year average. Active inventory in Montreal is 11,551. That is down 16% from the previous year and down 18.5% from the previous month. Currently, active inventory in Montreal is less than half of their five-year average. Montreal is critically low in inventory, and that's been pushing up those prices. That's what we can describe right now. Critically low inventory levels. And that's why I've got the Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer for Montreal strongly in the get moving category, because until you see changes, strong changes in both demand and supply, prices are gonna continue to increase in Montreal. Halifax, in one sentence, is rapidly depleting inventory, strong demand, and prices increasing. 563 houses were sold in Halifax. That's up 75% from last year. It's also down 15% from the month before. There are 957 active listings currently in Halifax. That is down 50% just from last year. It's also down 33% from the month before. Average price in Halifax, $362,000, up 11.8% from last year, up 1% from the month before. Bald Prairie Real Estate Biometer has to continue to stay and get moving, because this strong demand in Halifax and the really low inventory is continuing to push prices up, and we're heading into a spring market where demand is going to get even stronger. As you can see, 2020 was a pretty strong year for Canadian real estate. Many Canadian housing markets not only surpassed 2019, which for some areas was a softer year, but for the majority of Canadian markets, they also surpassed their five-year average. So fairly strong year for 2020 when a lot of people weren't exactly expecting 2020 to be a strong year after what happened in the spring. That leads us to 2021. I'm working on my 2021 forecast video where we're gonna go through all the bank forecasts, the real estate projections, all the different economic projections for the Canadian real estate market. I'm gonna break it all down for you guys and package it all into one update so you guys know what's going on. If you are thinking about buying a house this year and you'd like a little bit of help with some recommendations for a great real estate agent in your area, let me know. My contact information is in the description below and I'd be happy to set you up with a fantastic real estate agent in your area. A lot of the data for these market updates comes from agents in those local markets. I was like phoning them up and ask what's going on. What do I need to know about that specific market? If you're a first time home buyer, I got you covered too. First time home buyer playlist right there. You wanna check that one out. If you haven't checked out one of my newer segments, that's 2 Minute Tuesday. You can check that out right there. I cover one topic in 2 minutes or less. As always guys, thanks very much for watching.